Welcome to ryagurukul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about how to use external share add-ons in Confluence pages. When we talk about Confluence pages and the person who don't have account in Confluence, then it's a bit difficult to share the data with the person. But we have additional plugins or external plugins available for Confluence where we can share any page or any document with external user. So whenever that person is not having account, they will be able to see into their email ID or into the external link. So if you want to learn how we can use it or how we can do that, please watch complete video. And if you're visiting this channel at first time, consider subscribing and pressing bell icon for further updates. So external share links is having capability to share any documents or any data from Jira and Confluence to external customer. For the person who don't have this type of account, they will be able to use it. So for adding the external share links, simply we have to go to the manage apps. From the manage app sections, you'll be able to just search, find new apps. From here, enter the app name or the added add-ons name. So I'm just writing external share for Confluence. Now you can see this is a plugins which is available. So after adding this plugin, we will be able to share any of the data. So you can see here, this has been created by Old Street Solutions. If you want to know more about the Old Street Solutions, visit onto their professional website. Share pages with anyone is the major functionality of this plugins. Manage shared links, directly send links via email in the apps, viewed shared pages, and we can also do several other tasks like creating customizable unique links to our Confluence pages, share and add attachments and comments. No extra licenses are required. View all child pages from a single shared link. Set shared link expiration date and times. Protect links with passwords. Directly email links from within the app. Customize our email messages. Modify pages with custom CSS and HTML. So these are the functionalities. So for starting with this, simply add this or try it for free. Post are doing this. I've already added into my account, so I'm able to see it here. So navigate it to their space and open any documents which you want to share it. You can see here this icon is available here. So without using this, we have just one option to share. So when we are clicking, either we have to send via email or copy link and share with email ID. But for this, the data which I'm sharing with any other person, they have to be registered with Confluence and their account should already exist. If the person who don't have account, they can also use the data or see the content by just using share this link. So let me open any page and click on this. So after clicking on this, it will ask to create external share link. Click on create external share link and you'll be able to see this URL has been available. Copy this URL and paste it to next tab and you are able to see this tab is having exactly similar data which we have seen into our Confluence pages. So whatever data we have available into Confluence, that person can see it by using this URL. Now here we can modify the name, add the descriptions, and these all are the functionality where we can provide the customized detail to the end user. Whoever is reading this document, they can add the comments. So view comments, add comment, then view page labels, share child pages. So if you have any additional child pages into that particular documents, we can also share with them. Then remove unsupported macros. I just want to check at this and view attachments and add attachments whenever it is required. In security point of view, this is very much secure where person can set link expirations. So here you'll find it out hourly, day, week, month and yearly wise expiration date is available. So after this date, it will automatically expire, and the person, the link received to the person, they won't be able to access it. Even we can also set expire at a certain time and date. Apart of that, if we want to add any password to the document, so that password will be applied to our document. So whenever person who don't have this password, they won't be able to access it. So I'm just clicking generate random password, but we can also define or add our own password. We can also share with selected user. So this is the facilities available in this. Then let's go ahead and click on save, and this detail will be saved successfully. But if you want to share with any external customer, either you can send by email or just copy this UR and share with that person. They will be able to see this page, and you can see here this nicely generated detail is available here. Now let's perform some comment task. So let me add here. So because we have saved with the password, and then definitely whenever the person who is accessing the page, they will be able to get password protected screen. So from here we can share this document and copy the password. So let me copy this and enter the password here, and this document will be open clearly, and that person can use any data whatever they want. If they want to add any additional comments, they will be able to add it. So here I'm just writing Deepak here and comment. They can also specify with email ID as well, but after saving this, this comment will be successfully added. And when I will refresh this page, I will be able to see this comment is available here. And this is anonymous comment where we can see the username with the external share for Confluence is available here. Now, if I will add the comment from here, same comment will be updated into the share link as well. So this is to and through where we can add the comment and see it according to and through basis. So this is comment two. Click on save, and the same comment will be updated into this page. So let's refresh this, and we will be able to see second comments is available here. So this is how we can add comment and share. Now we can see here, at the time of creating a link, we have not specified or we have not selected share child pages. That's why this page alone is showing here when we are generating a link. But if we are selecting this show child pages as well and click on save, so whatever child pages is available here, that pages also will be visible under this link. So after saving this, we have to refresh this page, and we will be able to see child pages are also available. So it means we are not just sharing the main page, we are also sharing the child pages as well by using this external share for Confluence. And you can see exactly same pages are available in child pages, where we can add comments, upload attachments, and whatever actions we are performing to the main page or parent page, we can perform same actions on child pages as well. So this is the flexibility of external share links, where we are generating a link, external share link, for sharing the parent as well as child pages. The attachment, we can also add the attachment. So if you want to attach any documents from here, simply I will go to the download sections, and from here I will add the comment. So let me add it, any attachments, and you can see this attachment will be uploaded successfully. Now you can see second attachment is successfully added. When I will refresh this page, I will be able to see both the attachments are available here. So this is how we can add the attachments and share with any person. Now we can delete this link at any point of time whenever it is required. So let's say our purpose has been met. Simply we have to click on delete, and that document will be deleted successfully. So if I will delete this document, will be no more available. Now let's go to the settings tab and see what all settings we can perform it. Now in this actions, if I want to disable it, I will be able to disable it from the from here. In global setting, we can also specify it accordingly. So you can see complete detail is available. How many times I have accessed the page, you can see it from here. Now space configurations, in space configurations, if I want to disable the comments, the comment field will disable successfully when I will click on save. This comment will be disabled from this page. So let me refresh this, and you can see we have the additional security options where we can enable and disable it at any point of time. We can also disable other features according to our requirement. So let me allow view and add. We can also specify allow only view options, or either we can specify view and add. So both the options will be available here. So accordingly, we can do that. Now, if I want to, so right now it's in enable external share for the space, but if we want, we can remove it accordingly. So let me keep the same settings. In the global settings options, we will find it out. We have permission settings, custom email, email template, which we can set it accordingly. If we want to add group of members who can access this link, so we can add it from here. So if you want to add or see multiple links, we will be able to see it. And even we can create the multiple links from here only. So let me go to this page. Now, let's say we have two teams and we want to share this document with two separate teams. So I can create two separate links. One can be used for DevOps teams and other can be used for UAT team or testing team. So this is how we can create a custom links and share with two different set of people. And when I will refresh this page, I will be able to see two different links are available. Your links, you can see it here. So right now I did not access the second links page. That's why it's showing zero, and we have not set any password. That's the reason it is showing blank. And even we have not specified the expiration time. So whatever data, we will fill it up here. Same thing will be available for us. So this will be very easy to share any external documents, and they will be able to see exactly in the same format. So basically this has been creating HTML or CSS label combination template where we viewer can have exactly same replica of this documents, and they can comment and add attachment as well. So that's all about creating external share link in Confluence. Hope you enjoyed the session. If you think so, this is really useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.